Now it's time to talk about the third part of your PEE paragraph, the explanation.
By the end of this video, you should be able to answer these three questions. What does the explanation do? How does the explanation relate to thinking? And how does the explanation relate to the evidence?
The explanation is by far the most difficult part of the PEE paragraph. It's also the longest. In your notes, go ahead and start a new heading labeled Explanation. And this is the note that you should have about the explanation. Your explanation explains the connection between your evidence and your point. Go ahead and pause the video and copy that into your notes. Underneath that definition of explanation, you should also copy these notes. The explanation needs to be at least 3 to 5 sentences and hopefully longer. And that your explanation should point to specific words and ideas from your evidence and make connections to those words and ideas. So this is our original PEE, and you can see that the explanation is the part that's all in green. Notice that every single part of my paragraph has a color. Everything in your paragraph is always either a point that you're making, evidence that you're providing, or explanation. There are no other parts of your paragraph, and so every time you do a PEE paragraph, you should be able to color code it 3 colors and have every single word colored. Let's take a look at the explanation just by itself. The explanation here reads, "The idea that Parvana knew this shows us that Parvana is thinking about this and that she is getting courage from the thought. It was brave that Parvana even volunteered to help find her father. The fact that she purposefully searches her mind for sources of courage shows that she isn't unafraid, but that she has the qualities it takes to confront one's fears." That's a pretty good explanation. But how do you write an explanation like this? Well, I'm going to teach you how to think in a way that will lead to a good explanation. For an example, we're going to think about the words dark and how the word dark makes something scary. Is that true? Does the dark make something scary?
For somebody that thinks that dark equals scary, they might come up with some explanation sentences something like this.
The dark is scary because it is black and we can't see. This is what makes the dark so scary. But this is not a very good explanation. It's very what we call shallow or superficial. It doesn't explain a whole lot, and it just basically repeats the fact that the dark makes something scary. But the truth is, the dark does not make anything scary. Infants, when they're first born, are not afraid of the dark, because the dark is not scary to them. The dark is natural. So what makes the dark scary? It's our associations, or the things that we learn about the dark, that turn it into a scary thing when we get older. The word dark goes into our brains, and we realize that we can't see. And because we can't see, we can't really defend ourselves. And because we can't defend ourselves, we realize that there could be monsters in there, and that if there are monsters in there, they might kill you. And that creates a fear reaction. Rather than this explanation, we want to go through all the steps in our thinking. And if we go through all the steps in our thinking and explain each one, we end up with an explanation more like this. The dark makes us unable to defend ourselves or see if there is a danger. As kids, we are bombarded with tales of monsters and witches who are out to eat us or worse. These beings famously lurk in dark places like inside closets and under beds at night. In the dark, these things may be able to hurt us. This is what makes the dark such a fearful thing. You can see here the connection that I made to all the steps in my thinking. So let's go back to our explanation here. In order to see what inspired this explanation, we actually need to take a step back and go back to the original point. The point's going to tell us what two things we need to connect in our explanation. In this case, we need to connect Parvana to being a brave person. So we know that we're going to start with Parvana, and that our endpoint needs to be that Parvana is brave. We can see that in our point, but how do we get there?
We're going to rely on keywords and ideas from our evidence in order to give us enough ideas and material to write our explanation. We can see within our evidence that Parvana does go to find Father, and that while she's going to find Father, she is afraid. She's not without fear. Then we see that Parvana reminds herself of this story, the story of Malali, and she tells herself that Malali wouldn't be afraid as a way to make herself not afraid. She goes deeper into the story telling herself that Mullally would form an army and lead it into the storming of the prison as a way to inspire herself.
So these become the steps in our thinking that we need to take in order to go from Parvana to brave. We need to recognize that Parvana is afraid, but that when she's afraid, she reminds herself of this heroic story. We also need to take into account that she was brave enough to try and find her father to begin with, and that even though she feels fear, she overcomes fear. It's all of these things taken together that make Parvana brave, and that's what our explanation points out.
Let's take a closer look at the connections between our evidence and our explanation. We highlighted all the parts of our evidence that we thought might be useful. Let's see how they show up in our explanation. We mentioned that Parvana goes to find father, and in our explanation, we mentioned that Parvana even volunteered to help find her father. We also identified that Parvana does become afraid, and we mentioned that in our explanation, that she isn't unafraid. We then identified in our evidence that Parvana says to herself that Mullally wouldn't be afraid, and in our explanation, we comment on this by saying that Parvana is getting courage from the thought. And finally, we focused on how Parvana was thinking about the fact that Mullally would form an army and lead it into the storming of the prison. And we commented on this in our explanation when we said that Parvana is purposefully searching her mind for sources of courage. Hopefully you can see here how our evidence gives us all the material that we need in order to make a lot of thoughtful connections that are useful in our explanation. Now that we've studied the explanation, go ahead and stop and answer these three questions in your notebook before you move on to the next exercise.
Let's look at another way that we can develop good explanations. I'm going to give you a topic and an end point, and we're going to think about all the steps that need to be taken between those two points and all the connections that need to be made in order to connect them together. So if I look at school equals success, is that true? Does going to school equal success in the future? Well, not necessarily. So if we go back to the idea of school, what's the first step that takes us in the path of success? Well, we learn things about subjects like math and science. Those subjects become our foundations for college. In college, we learn social skills and collaboration. And combined together, knowledge in math and science and the skills of collaboration make us better workers. Being a better worker is what helps us become a success. So we can see now that we've made a direct line connecting how school makes us successful in the future. So this is the paragraph that we're going to develop connecting these two things. Going to school allows people to learn more about subjects like math and science. These subjects help prepare students for college. School also helps students learn social skills like how to make friends and cooperate with others. These skills and abilities are what makes good workers and future leaders. People like this will be promoted in their workplaces, helping them to become financially successful in the future.
Now it's your turn. Go ahead and pick one of these pairs of ideas and see if you can link them together using the same type of process that we just looked at. Do this before you move to the next exercise.
It's time to return back to our four PEE paragraphs that we've been working on. We developed our points and we wrote our evidence, and now it's time to write our explanations. You'll write one explanation for each one of these four paragraphs. And when you're done, you're going to turn it into your teacher. Thank you for your time and attention learning how to do PEE paragraphs. It's a skill that's going to pay off throughout school. You can apply these paragraphs to almost every subject that you have to write in. Thank you and have a great day.